Alarming. Thanks very much for that, Barbara. Let's get to the race, the next election that is only 2 years away, but many are certainly already getting ready for it. One man already eyeing the 2008 presidential race is Iowa's Democratic Governor Tom Vilsack. He's a two-term governor and the first Democrat to file for a run for the White House. Governor Vilsack is joining us. You filed those exploratory papers in recent days, Governor. Why do you want to run for president? Why do you want to be president?
Well, first of all, Wolf, we didn't file exploratory papers. We actually filed the papers to begin the run.
So you've gone beyond the exploratory process. You're not an explorer like John McCain. You're beyond.
Well, the bottom line is you make a decision and you go with it. That's the kind of person I am, and that's the kind of leader I want to be. Once you've made the decision, there's no reason to explore. You jump in with both feet.
The first contest is in your home state of Iowa. So you presumably have a real advantage there. You've been elected twice. Everybody in Iowa knows you. Are you hoping to scare off other Democrats from even running in Iowa?
Not at all, Wolf. I think every candidate for president who's interested in being the president of the United States needs to come to Iowa, and we need to campaign together. We need to debate the issues. We need to have fun. We need to make sure that the field is wide open. And so I have, in specific conversations with many people who are thinking about this, invited them to come to Iowa, and I hope that they do come.
Because as you remember, back in 1992, and I remember it very vividly, Tom Harkin, the Democratic senator from Iowa, was running for president. He ran, in fact, as a favorite son in Iowa, and he scared off Bill Clinton and a whole bunch of other people from even running in Iowa.
Well, this is a much different situation and a much different time.
So you think you're going to get Hillary Clinton, Barack Obama, and other potential Democrats to challenge you in your own home state?
Well, I don't think it's about challenging me, Wolf. I think it's about talking about the future of this country and whether or not we're going to have a government, unlike the government that we have today, that really cares about tomorrow and really acts as if tomorrow matters. You can't have deficits. You can't have a lack of discussion about health care and energy security and a national and foreign policy that has essentially alienated most of our friends and somehow united most of our enemies. We need to have a debate about that in the state of Iowa and across the country, and I welcome that debate. I look forward to that debate.
You must be heartened by this fact that of the Democratic presidents who have been recently elected, Jimmy Carter was a little-known governor from Georgia. Bill Clinton was a little-known governor from Arkansas, both managed to get to the White House. You're a relatively little-known, at least nationally known, governor from Iowa. Is that what you're basing your hope on?
No, I'm basing it on the fact that I think I have better ideas in terms of the direction of this country. And the reality is I look forward to learning more from America and having America learn more about me. I think it's going to be a great journey, and I look forward to it.
Well, help us understand a little bit more about you. I remember meeting you several times when I covered earlier races in the Iowa caucuses. But tell our viewers what you bring, for example, to the table that the front runner, Senator Clinton, would not bring.
Well, I'm not going to compare myself to any particular candidate, but let me talk about what I do bring. And that is, as a governor, I have focused, for example, on one issue that I think is very important to the fate of this country and the future of this country, and that's energy security. I don't believe there's anybody else in the country that's done more. The state of Iowa is now the leader of renewable fuel production. We're one of the leaders of wind production. We have really been on the front lines of creating a more secure Iowa, and I think we can take that message across the country to make America more energy secure. So I'm happy to talk about these issues. As a governor, we've helped create jobs. We've improved education. We've expanded access to health care. We've improved the economy of this state, and these are all going to respond to the anxieties that so many Americans today feel. We are an anxious nation,
all right.
And on election night, we began to change the direction of this nation. We just have to get the job done in 2008.
A big issue hovering over the last election and maybe the next election will be Iraq. Are you among those Democrats who want to see the U.S. start pulling out troops within the next 4 to 6 months?
I wouldn't put a specific timetable on it, Wolf, but I do think that we need to be strategic about where the troops are located. I would, if I were president today, sit down with my military advisors and talk about how we could remove troops from the southern part of the country and from Baghdad and the central part of the country. I think what we have done is we've created a culture of dependency there, and we have basically put ourselves in a position where the Iraqis are not making the decisions that only they can make. I would still maintain for a period of time troops in the northern part of the country to make sure that Turkey did not interfere, to make sure that we could send a very specific message to Iran that we do in fact have a military option, which clearly we don't have today as we discussed diplomatically the nuclear issue with that country. And if, in fact, chaos continues to reign, we would be in a position to respond to it. I think it's more than just military. I think we have to look at the reconstruction plan, encourage countries from the region to get involved, and I think we also have to build local governing capacity, something that there's been very little discussion about.
All right.
But the reality is, if you want basic services to folks, it's local government that provides them.
Should the U.S., if you were president, be talking directly to Syria and Iran to try to help out the situation in Iraq?
Well, not only to help out the situation in Iraq, but to basically engage a discussion about the Middle East as a whole. The fact that we're not talking to Iran, to Syria, to North Korea, I think has made it a much more dangerous world than it needed to be. And we need to aggressively engage in discussions and conversations to figure out diplomatically how we can avert very serious problems with a nuclear bomb in Iran and with the current situation in North Korea.
The outgoing governor of Iowa, he's not messing around. He's running for president already and making no bones about it. Governor Vilsack, we'll hope you'll be a frequent guest here in the Situation Room.
Thanks, Wolf.
Thanks to you as well. And still to come.